Hey guys, what's up? My name is Nix, and this video is about my rebuild of our thesis project.
First of all, I want to talk about why did I do this here? Why did I rebuild this machine from bottom up? In fact, it was already done. Well, when we built this machine, I was not satisfied with the results. On the actual thesis defense, we struggled a lot and very disappointed because it didn't work at first. We had to be the last presenters because we did a rewire of the whole thing. And it was very frustrating with all the sleepless nights and money spent on this, and it won't work. But miraculously, after the last presenter before us, it finally worked. This experience of mine can't be vanished from the bottom of my memory. And during the quarantine, I decided to rebuild this, since there's nothing to do, and I love doing engineering stuff. Let's begin. At day one, I cut the case in half since it's very large, and the space inside was not really utilized. This guy here was a fail because of the structure of the container. When dispensing, the rice won't fall all by itself most of the times, and we had to do this. So I thought of a better design on the rice container. I decided to make it a one piece with the whole body of the case. Day 2, I cut a piece for the back panel of the case, this guy here. Day 3, I did all the 4 triangles for the bottom part of the container. Day 4, I smoothened all the pieces I cut. I was kinda lazy during these days, so I did mostly this.
Welcome to Mobile Legends! 5 seconds till the enemy.
Day 5 up to day 12, I worked on the software. Most of my work here is on the software side. Let me tell you why. When we were building this machine before, we encountered a lot of problems, and almost all of them are pointing to this guy. This is called a load cell. It's used on digital weighing scale, and without this, there wouldn't be a Sakto. But why did it become my biggest problem on building this? Isn't it ironic? Huh. Well, simply because load cells are very sensitive on voltage changes. And when voltage rises or drops, the calibration of the load cell changes. And when its calibration changes, the accuracy of the dispensing mechanism drops. You don't want to get 150 grams of rice instead of supposedly having 250 grams, right? So, I did a ton of research on this. Luckily, I found this library right here that is written by most of it is programmed through C++ and C, just like a regular Arduino module. I modified the program to be more user-friendly, not by a programmer, but by a regular user. I was able to put it in the system in the sense that a load cell can be recalibrated through a 4x4 keypad and a 4x16 LCD display. Here's one of the tests. Through this added feature, well, smart calibration as I call it, recalibration of the load cell wouldn't be a pain in the ass. Day 13, it's welding time! My baby right here just arrived, so I can continue the case. I finished most of the body, but there's a bit of a problem. I didn't expect that welding thin stainless steel could be this hard. Since I have no experience on welding before, this was the result. There were a lot of holes. At the time being, I didn't know what to do to fix this. Day 14 up to 15, I'm almost finished on the case. I found a possible solution to the problem. How about using a stick glue? Well, at first, it sounded silly, but it turned out to be effective. It covered all the unnecessary holes and gave me a smile. Day 16, I did the motor, placed it on the bottom part of the container, and again, it turned out really bad. I almost destroyed the whole triangle thing, but at the end of the day, I was able to finish it with my new best friend. Day 17, the container's finished! Day 18 up to 20, I did all the necessary cuts on the body. Day 21 up to 22, it's soldering time! I compiled all the hardware, put it on the case, and started making the motherboard, which is, by the way, a prototype board. Day 23. I'm still working on the board. Day 24 up to 28. I finished all other things on the case, like LED lights, side panel cover, which is partly burned, by the way, because of welding, the weighing scale, and finally, the machine is done. As you can see, side panel of the case is plywood. This is because I ran out of stainless steel thing, and I don't have money to buy one. This I did a very good job on cable management, right? Now here's the raw footage of the actual working of the machine, including other features. I removed the background sounds because it was so noisy.
And this video reached its end, and I want to thank everyone, especially God, mother, and my girlfriend who is there for me, supporting me always. Thank you. And to you who is watching this, thank you because you reached this far.